This is what is left of Light Corner Building. It is one of five historic buildings demolished by the city in the last weeks. Almost every corner of the city is under construction. Low-rise buildings are being replaced with multi-story structures almost overnight. I'm in one of Dar es Salaam's old buildings that is almost 70 years old, and as you can see here, it's in a bad state of disrepair. The ceiling board has completely given away. There are gaping holes in it, and the wooden boards are rotting away. There are those that argue that such buildings are health hazards, and that is why they should be torn down. A majority of Dar es Salaam's historic buildings are managed by the National Housing Corporation. It says no building is torn down without consultation with the Antiquities Department at the Ministry of Tourism. Under the Antiquities Act, buildings of more than 100 years old automatically become heritage sites. The law says any changes must be made after consultation with the Ministry of Tourism. However, there are some who say the law is not clear enough and that people are taking advantage of that.
All decision which is taken by these owners of these laws are independent of antiquities knowledge. That is the problem. Because once you hear that the building is pulled down, it is pulled down already when you hear, and you can do nothing. Just as what has happened recently.
But conservationist groups say it is all about a lack of maintenance. Their argument is that these buildings could be saved.
I have no reason to think why they shouldn't be maintained, especially when the rents have all been going up. So what stops these buildings from being beautifully maintained, painted nicely, you know, so that actually they look beautiful?
With more and more people moving from rural areas into the city, there's clearly a need for development. But how to strike the balance between preserving the past and providing for the future is not an easy one. Tulanana Bohela, BBC News, Dar es Salaam.